Let inverted or upside down triangle x be defined as x plus 1 over x. Let me write that down. Inverted triangle x is equal to x plus 1 over x for all non-zero integers x. All right? If inverted or upside down triangle x is equal to t, so if this whole thing is equal to t, where t is an integer, which of the following is a possible value of t? So let's think about this a little bit. So what you could try to do is you could take each of these choices and substitute it in for t, and then try to solve for x and see if you can find x's that are integers. But instead of doing each of them one by one, let's just solve this. Let's just rearrange this equation where we can solve for x as a function of t, and then we could try the different t values out then and see, hey, can we get a non-zero integer value for x? So if we take this, and if we multiply both sides by x, we're going to get x times x is x squared. 1 over x times x is 1. And then t times x is tx. Now it looks like we have a quadratic. We could try to get into a standard form so that we could try to factor it. So let's subtract tx from both sides. And so if we subtract tx from both sides, we are going to be left with, on the left-hand side, x squared minus tx plus 1, and that's going to be equal to 0. Now this is interesting right over here. We have kind of a traditional quadratic equation right over here, and we just have to think about, well, what values of t can we actually factor this so that we get integer solutions for x? So actually, let's just write down all the options over here. So if t is equal to 1, then this thing is going to be x squared minus 1x, or we could just say x squared minus x plus 1. If t is equal to 0, then this middle term disappears, and you're just left with x squared plus 1. If t is equal to negative 1, then this thing becomes x squared negative negative 1, so it's plus x plus 1. If t is equal to negative 2, then you get x squared plus 2x plus 1. And then if t is equal to, running out of colors, if t is equal to negative 3, you have x squared plus negative 3, negative negative 3, so that's plus 3x plus 1. So which of these can you factor? Well, it might jump out at you that, hey, this is a perfect square right over here. I can factor this one. This is x plus 1 times x plus 1. 1 plus 1 is 2, and 1 times 1 is 1 right over here. So because I can factor this, I know that this right over here is going to be my answer. If t is equal to negative 2, if t is equal to negative 2, then all of this stuff boils down to that. And we could say that x squared minus t, which is plus 2, plus 2x plus 1 is equal to 0. The left-hand side is just x plus 1 squared is equal to 0, which means that x plus 1 is equal to 0, which means that x would be equal to negative 1. So when t is equal to negative 2, that means that x is equal to negative 1. And the negative 1 is a non-zero integer. You could look at these other ones and you can say, well, yeah, this is very hard to factor. I need to take the product of two numbers whose positive 1, and their sum is negative 1. Well, I can't think of two integers that would do that. Same thing here, x squared plus 1. How do I factor that? Well, there's no obvious way, at least in my brain, of factoring that. Same thing over here, two numbers whose product is 1 and whose sum is positive 1. Well, I need two integers, and I can't think of any there. And same thing over here, two numbers whose product is 1 and whose sum is 3. Can't think of it. But this one right over here, you can.